Hi, everyone. My name is Donna Sullivan. I've been thinking about our mission statement and would like to share a few of my thoughts with you. If you're like me, you didn't know that love God, love people, live it out, that you hear every week is actually the mission statement of our church. This morning, I was reading the Messages translation of Malachi for my devotional, and I found something that struck me. God was talking to the Israelites through Malachi, and in chapter 1, verse 6, he said, "Isn't it true that a son honors his father and a worker his master? So if I am your father, where's the honor? If I'm your master, where is the respect?" Okay, loving God involves honor and respect. Next, the teacher in me kicked in, and I went to the dictionary. I looked up love, and all five definitions talked about feelings. I suppose that's true, but Christian love should also include actions. We may feel love for God or for someone else, but they can't receive that love if we don't show it to them. In Malachi, God asks for honor and respect. Honoring God involves fulfilling an agreement with him, an action. We must hold him in high esteem and do what he asks. We must show him that his commands are uppermost in our minds and are reflected in our actions. This is where love people comes in, and then live it out with our actions. We might send a note or a card to comfort, encourage, or to celebrate with someone. We could serve food in a soup kitchen or hand out food at a food giveaway. We could know someone that's struggling. We could tell them of the peace that we get from God and invite them to our church. We could also invite them into our home. A personal relationship with someone could influence them eternally. I've thought of these few things to do. Now let's pray that we will have the courage to do just one this week. Heavenly Father, please give us the courage to follow your command to first love you and second love others. Be with us this week as we look for ways to show your love in our confused and struggling world. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a blessed week.